All right, hey, we're back. So, let me just check if the audio. Yeah, I think the audio is fine. All right, so I have a few things to update to you guys. First of all, thanks for those of you who stuck around to watch the my trip to the bottom of the Skull Cavern. It's been a while since I ever took up such a big task, and I didn't think that I'd want to really do it so soon, but oh well, I got it done. So there is that. Now I did a few things, right? I did a few things. I went to the Skull Cavern on a high luck day and I bombed the entire place, and guess what I found? Yep, I found a bat fossil. So and just to let you all know specifically, I found it on floor 7. So maybe floors 5 and above have a chance of dropping it. But you really have to mine quite a bit. So I nuked a whole bunch of rocks and eventually I got the bat. So now it looks like the only fossil that I have left to find is most likely in the golden coconuts. And it has not been easy to collect them. So this is a bit of a risky task. Either way, since the luck is today is an off luck day, as you saw from the report, unlikely we'll be doing anything. I will also be doing a 100 Omni Geode opening the next time we come across what do you call this a good luck day again. So until then, there are a few other things that I would like to settle. Oh, we've got a lot of wine that has been aged. So I got a few things, right? I did the wizard's task, which gave me this thing, the mini obelisk. So I think it was one where I have to go and find ectoplasm from ghosts. So I took a trip to the regular mines. I went below floor 70 and so on, and I just farmed a whole bunch of ghosts until eventually one of them did drop an ectoplasm. It took me like half a day worth of farming in the mines. I'm not sure. It does seem to be quite rare actually. And ghosts themselves are quite rare, so it took me a while to get it, but I finally got them. Basically, they just allow me to teleport between locations in my farm. So I'll show you how that works. The other thing that I got was fairy dust. I can't remember exactly who gave this, but it's not that unique or what anything like that, but what it does allow me to do is it instantly completes a mesh machine's upgrade, right? So let's say I put truffle into the truffle oil maker. If I pop fairy dust, it immediately makes it immediately turns it into oil. So it doesn't seem especially useful because it's so expensive. It needs diamond and fairy rose just to make one of these. So maybe you want to use this on something like a incubator. So yeah, maybe just an incubator, because those are like the really long things. Other than those, I don't really see this being too useful because it says cakes, furnaces, and other refining equipment. So actually, I'm not even sure if you can use this on an incubator. Yeah, it just seems like a really expensive thing, and I probably will not be investing on any of these. I just made one just for the collection, and I tested it on a keg. Essentially, what it does is it just if a wine is aging, it doesn't complete the aging. It just ages it by one step. So if it's regular quality, it takes it to silver and then gold and then iridium. It just does step by step. So you need three of these, and it's way too expensive. So unlikely I'll be investing in anything of such. So let's pop our ancient fruit wine to get them to age. I think that's pretty much all I have to update. There wasn't anything too exciting besides, of course, the bats. The bats was pretty cool when I found the mummified bat. What do you call this fossil? So it shows up in like a regular stone, I think. I just mined a bunch of stones and eventually it showed up. It wasn't in some sort of what do you call this monster or anything in particular, because I got two of those. I actually used one to complete the task, and I stored the other one here, just to make sure that if it really is rare, I want to just keep one extra for the sake of the collection. Okay, let's see. I can switch to truffle and start pumping out more truffle oil. So economy is great, as you can see. I have a positive income, which is all I really care about. I don't really need to get the best amount of money in the world. Let's sell all these wine, and I've also pumped up the number of kegs. So later when I go inside, you'll see a lot of kegs, and I've also pumped up the number of crystallariums. So we're making a lot more diamonds than before. So let's just go and get some fruits before we get our kegs going. So over here, this is one obelisk. I can just teleport through it, and I put one more at the bottom of the farm just to make it easier for me. But that's about it. Other than that, I don't really see it being that impressive or anything like that. It's just great to have something that allows you to move quicker around the farm. If you maybe it's more useful for the new farm, because I heard the island farm is pretty big and complicated to get around. I could be wrong though, but yeah, so it might be good for that. Like the colors I have here, I would like some red slime, but other than that, the colors are really nice. I want to keep it as colorful as possible, just for the fun of it. Okay, so now that we checked those, I'm gonna not bother with my animals today. I think I've done enough with them. So we are collecting bananas, and we are almost at 10. Once we do get 10, the first thing we are gonna be doing is to get the obelisk to teleport us to the island, so we can start our day early. We don't need to rely on Willy, and we save a lot of travel time. So that's most likely what we're gonna do. Got some, and I also put a tapper on the mahogany tree just to see what happens. It just gives sap, nothing out of the ordinary. But I'll just leave the tapper there just to remind myself of my own failure. Yeah, unfortunately, it's just that. I got almost 10 out of 10 rainbow trouts, and I'm starting to find, I mean, my sea cucumbers are growing reasonably well. So while all that is taking, Juno was dancing, really? Why don't you collect these instead of dancing? Okay, sorry, I'm a little bit harsh with my Junimos. Should probably give them more freedom. Anyway, I'm not a big fan of micromanagement. I just prefer to trust someone wholeheartedly or get things done on my own. That's usually the way I roll. All right, so let's go in here. Excuse me. Let's get some of these kegs filled up with some fresh peaches. And let's collect these peach wine. So as you can see, I got a lot of extra kegs. I'll let the peach tree in the house spawn a little more peaches. So what we are chasing after is robins. what do you call this? Hearts. We need to get more affiliation with Robin because we want to get more stuff from her, and I think there's some valuable stuff that we'll be getting from her, and I'll update on that. But until then, let me just dump all the. I think I can keep one. It's fine. Let's carry the peach wine. Let's sell these roe. Some sap. That's fine. We actually need to collect a single peach for Robin. I just realized that. Never mind. We'll start our day by making more caffeine, and then we can make our way to Robin. So okay, here we go. Take a drink. So I could probably put one obelisk here just to get myself to the greenhouse right away. But other than that, I don't really see it being that useful. I don't know, maybe there's a better way to use it. Let me know how you guys use the obelisk. Maybe there is a better way to do it. Okay, let's just check on this. Has not been watered, so let's pop that. Right, so today is Monday, so we can check what the new board task is, and we can probably get working on that. And tomorrow we'll be getting our new obelisk because we'll have 10 bananas. So we can do that. And if there's a luck day. Oh. Okay, this is a hot event. Okay. Yes. Okay. Yes, right. So we need to get the fruit block crafted. That's how we do the mermaid puzzle, apparently. Okay. So yeah, that's great to know. Robin has given us that. Let's just continue making friends with her so we can get more stuff. So I really need to max out these hearts on a lot of characters. As you can see, I haven't really been the best at giving. And I realize I should probably do more of that. Okay, let's go and check the board tasks. Oh, excuse me, lady. Could you like let my horse through? All right, let's go down here. Great. All right. Need 80 hardwood. Can you help? So I'm not sure what these give. Give me a sec. I think I'll look it up. Right, so I realized that both of them give similar quality stuff, not really anything exclusive. But the 80 hardwood seems like something that would be good for me to work on compared to 25 gold star vegetables. So we'll probably do that, I guess. Don't see anything else being that ideal. Yeah, okay. So let's make our way to the island and farm a little bit more coconut because when the luck day does come, we want to make sure we are ready with plenty of coconuts. Excuse me. Having a little bit of a sore throat, but I think I'll be fine. Okay, let's buy a ticket. Hopefully, this is our last ticket. Tomorrow's banana should solve that. Okay, we are running on caffeine. We seem good. All right, let's get to work. So now that we can craft flute blocks, where is it? Yeah, there we go. Now that we can craft these, we can actually start preparing for the mermaid puzzle. And just to make sure we know exactly what we are doing, let's take a peek. Oh, the stones are missing. So they only appear when the mermaid is there. Yeah, that seems a little unfortunate, but I'm guessing there's like six stones. So we need to have six blocks. That's pretty much what we're aiming for. Okay, let's go here to the west side of the island. Let's check a bit on our farm over here. We got some banana also growing here. Everything else seems good. Let's just sweep our way through these. Okay, any coconuts here? I don't think there are any coconuts. Yeah, there's one here. Okay, I'll take that. Okay, there's one there. Not that many coconuts spawning. Okay, there's one more here. Okay, and we got a golden, that's nice. So this thing makes it nine coconuts. We need one more, then we can exchange that. Let's just farm these. We do have to remind ourselves to farm some hardwood. Okay. Are there any coconuts here? Nope, none whatsoever. Let's go up here. Let's go through here. How many walnuts? I have nine walnuts, huh? Okay. I'll keep an eye on that figure. I think we've checked all the trees there. So let's go to the dig site. So we don't have that much to do in the cave now, except farm dragon tooth if we need that. We do need 10 for the obelisk. So once we get the obelisk done, then we can farm some more on a high luck day, because it does drop, like the cave does drop a lot of prismatic. So I would want to farm there as much as possible just to increase my chances. We can also get all these. Why am I facing that side? Doesn't make sense. Okay. There we go. Nice. Let's see where this kid is going. There's some trees here that I could shake, but I don't think they have any. No, the kid is. What's he doing? Hey, kid. Oh, there you are. How to make friends with the kid? Actually, I need to find out what he likes. Oh well, we'll do that some other time. Let's find a few more coconuts, get them going. So, if you have not decided how to spend your golden walnuts purchasing these things, get this first. The trading post is right here when you come in from the dock. And what this allows you to do is trade in coconuts for golden coconuts, and you can trade in a whole bunch of other things. But you can get your banana fast by farming dragon tooth as well. But it seems like the coconut is essentially what you want to really farm. There's this thing, but I don't really need it because I have a lot of iridium sprinklers, and I don't see the need for this. But that's just an extra thing that you can get if you want. It's like an Ash Ketchum hat. Other than that, everything else seems quite straightforward. I want to see how much mangoes and bananas cost when I start selling them. Maybe they are quite valuable, I'm not entirely sure. Okay, so let's look for more coconuts, and then I think we can head back and start farming some hardwood. Let's check in here. We haven't been in here for a while. I wonder if anything has spawned here. This place is a little mysterious in the sense where sometimes there's like leaves that I can barely see on the ground, and I still haven't figured this thing out. I have no idea what it is. Give me one sec. All right, so after looking it up, I feel really stupid because it really looks like shape of a banana. Yeah, there we go. Oh, okay, what do you do? Not nice. So, is it a one-time thing? It looks like a one-time thing now that the flames are going. That's pretty cool. So you need bananas for those. Right, at least now you guys will know that as well. Yeah, let's just pick the fiddlehead ferns. I don't really use them, but I would like to keep some. So we'll be a day behind on the banana for the obelisk, but I think it's fine. Golden walnuts are essential. So now we have 12. We can actually start to work on something else. Let's see what else needs golden walnuts. I'm sure there is a parrot somewhere that I may have missed. Let me think. Actually, you know what? Just give me a sec. Okay, I think we have actually unlocked almost every parrot's task. So there's actually not much for us to do with our golden walnuts, which is great to know. But we can continue collecting them apparently. So I want to do this mermaid's task. Today is not really the day. I just realized that I can till this. This looks like also tillable. Ah, there's another walnut there. Sweet. Let's also till this place because it looks like something. Okay, let's till here. Here. I think that's about it. Okay, so here's something a little cute. The Pirate's Cove, right. So this is where we got our stingrays. And it looks really cool. Apparently pirates will appear here on some days, and but it can't be a rainy day. That's the thing. There is one walnut there, and this is where you can fish your stingrays. So today the pirates are off duty apparently, because we don't see any. But I would like to come back and try to see if there is anything else we can do. So we can focus on crafting the fruit blocks for the mermaid, and hopefully get a few more walnuts. But we're close to, like, we got a good number of golden coconuts. But I would like to have more. You know what? Let's return. Let's just pay a quick visit to the desert and see if there's any coconuts for sale. Because that is possible. Sometimes there are coconuts for sale here. Nice, you are open. That's great. Right, there we go. Let's buy 10 coconuts. It's fantastic. So we can convert these coconuts on another day. Let's also walk around here and see. The thing about these trees is that they don't really show when they have coconuts, but you can still shake them and you might get some. So let's just shake these. Okay, it looks like there's nothing there. Let's shake this one. Okay, kind of unfortunate today. Okay, let's see what else you sell. Artifact Trove. Okay, let's check down here. There's one last 3D shake. All right, there we go. So there's nothing, unfortunately, but we'll make do with what we have. All right, so let's get all these stashed, and hopefully tomorrow there's a lucky day for us to crack open all of these Omni Geodes, which is what I'm looking forward to. So let's just stash these, and I will be right back. Yes, praise the gods. It's a luck day. All right, boys, we're gonna get this thing done. Oh, girls, I really do not discriminate. So it looks like today is luck day, which is a great day for us to crack open these coconuts. And I don't think we will have enough bananas to travel to the island. So before we proceed, what we have to do is we have to convert a few. I realize I actually stashed some coconuts somewhere in my house. So I'm gonna take all my coconuts and gonna get them converted to golden ones, and then we're gonna do a big opening. So let's just leave these. These are not very urgent for us. So over here we can stash our bombs. We don't need this for the time being. Oh, actually, you know what? Let's not put them here. Let's put them here. This is a better place to keep them. I'm gonna keep the iridium bar here. I'm gonna keep the wood here. I'm gonna keep the stone here. The panning tool. What else can I keep? I can keep a sight, I guess. Let's take a single shot of espresso. Let's keep the rest because eventually we'll be drinking the luck stuff. Crab cakes. Yeah, I think everything else is fine. Iridium, it's fine to keep it because we'll be collecting a lot of those as we crack open the geodes. So let's go in here. Let's just get the last banana so we don't lose track. Nine bananas. Cool. Okay. So now all we gotta do is we gotta get to the island, convert these coconuts, and then we gotta come back. Oh yeah, and I found out that that kid actually likes rainbow shells and some other shells apparently, but he does like rainbow shells. So I think we can actually start collecting some rainbow shells to give the kid as and when required. I think Willy's boat moves at 8, so let's just collect these while we wait. Hey, that rhymed. I know, it's lame, it's lame. Okay, let's sell these off. Okay, come on, come on. Yeah, okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's get a ticket. Let's go to the island. Cool. So if you see the kid, you're gonna stuff him with rainbow shells. I know it sounds horrifying, but it's not as bad as it sounds. Okay, let's come here. Let's get three golden coconuts. Cool. All right, so we've got more than 10. That'll be a decent opening, I suppose. Okay, so we still have time to get back and check on Clint. So before we do that, let's find the kid and give him some rainbow shells. I just hope that he is here. Yes, he is. Fantastic. Yeah, okay, so he does like it. Great. Right, that's great news for us. Let's see. Okay, we are pretty clean on coconuts. I think we should be able to just teleport back. We don't have to worry about picking up anything else. Let's just go to Clint. We haven't really started on the hardwood quest, but I think it's fine. We can. It's not as urgent as this one, the town. Okay, all right. So let's check. Let's sort these out. Yeah, let's sell this one. Let's sort you out again. Let's go to Clint. Nice. Okay, so before we start this, I need to drink ginger ale. I need to pop a lucky lunch. Okay, so now I got plus 4. Right? Okay. Just talk to him, process geodes. Right, guys. Here we go. Here we go. Okay, that's trash. That's actually trash. Oh my god, that's so bad. Nope, still bad. Oh, that's terrible. I'm getting two of each. Oh, yes! Yes, we got it! We got it! Alright, I consider that a win. And another banana sapling? Sure, I'll take it. No problem. Right, now I'm absolutely fine with everything else. And we got a duplicate. Wow. Okay. Okay, that's great news for us. Okay, and now let's do these. Oh, yeah, boy. Here we go. Here we go. These are gonna be insane. 100 of these, huh? Okay. Ooh, what is that? Ancient drum. Yeah, I think I've got that before. Okay, let's keep going. Okay. What is this? Opal. Oh, okay. All right. Yeah, I have these ghost crystals. Not that uncommon. Okay. All right, I'm already starting to see a pattern. Yeah, these things are pretty common, huh? Okay. I also have not found a lot of other artifacts being used for crafting. Initially, they requested the dwarf machine or something, which I used to make the farm computer. But other than that, most of these have been useless. It's just kind of sad. I wish the fairy stone can become fairy dust. Like, you know, you just craft it into like 10 fairy dust or something, right? Okay, when we are out of room. So we can actually sell some of these because they're quite common. So let's sell that. Let's sell this. Start nailing this down. We can actually sell these iron because they're really common. We can sell the stone. We can sell the mahogany seed. Okay, that's sandstone. Yeah, okay, cool. Fire quartz, really common stuff. More stone, okay. A single stone, really? Okay. All right. Okay, I think we will stop at 60. Okay, let's sell fire quartz because they're quite common. Let's also sell the gold. I know it might hurt you, but I have a lot of gold. Okay, so we will stop at 60, and the reason for that is because I want to spend the Omni Geodes and other stuff, and I feel that at this point in the game, they don't really help me as much as the other things that I have. Okay, so before we head to the island, let's stash some of these stuff. Let's see. We have these. Okay. Let's just click these things and see what go in. eventually, they will fit in if they already have a copy. Yeah, I think that's pretty good. I think that's pretty good. Right, now we can keep the rest of these things. Stick these in artifacts. I'm gonna keep it. Let's keep the coal. Let's keep the iridium. All right, looking good. So we can store the artifact. In fact, we have a duplicate, so that's really awesome for us. So let's store the duplicate here. Let's keep these. Yeah, so plus 4 luck on a day that says that you have extra fortune seems to be the safest bet to do this. So yeah. Oh yeah, before I go, let's not forget. I stashed a whole bunch of things in here. I gotta pick them up. Darrow tubers, yeah. I'm gonna pick these up and leave them on the island because that's actually where they have the most value. Because I can easily plant them there and they will just grow regardless of the season, you know? Okay, so I feel pretty satisfied. I think we have got most of the island covered and this might be our last fossil. So let's go and get it done and let's see what happens. Do we have any caffeine left? Oh yeah, we do. Actually, you know what? Let's just leave our luck running for a bit. I think it's fine. Yeah, okay, I think it's fine. Right, here comes your golden coconut head. Donate the last piece. There's something waiting. Great. Let's see what you got. Oh, cutscene. Okay. Oh, wow. That looks pretty cool, actually. What is it, though? Okay. Ah. In a barn. In a barn. I see, so we can't use a coop, we need a barn. Yeah, I already have a single ostrich egg, and I got it from a golden coconut. Okay, I think I got it from a coconut. Okay, thanks, man. That's really nice of you. So let's collect my reward. Oh, okay, I'll take it. More banana saplings. Yep, so I've got a complete collection. Satisfying. Right, thank you. It's been fun dealing with you. And let's see what I need to craft the incubator. Hardwood cinder bone fragment. Now that ain't difficult, is it? That ain't difficult at all. Hardwood, cinder, and bone fragment. There we go. Let's craft our first ostrich incubator. Let's stash the bone. Let's stash the cinder. We actually have to remind ourselves to farm hardwood. So maybe I'll keep it. For now, at least. Let's keep the ostrich here. Do you think we can make it to money? Money is a tough one to get to. No, to create the barn. We have to go to Robin, actually. Yeah, that's gonna be a little tricky, huh? Where do we place the bond? I haven't thought that far, guys. Okay, this is exciting new stuff. Unless we decrease some of our barn animals, maybe the pigs. Should we? Yeah, I think I'll do that because I got a barn full of pigs because I rely a lot on truffle. But maybe it's time to have something different. And the pig barn, I rarely even go inside it. Yeah, alright. Let's put an ostrich incubator here. And let's get an ostrich egg. So let's sell some of these pigs. This one is young. 15,000. 18,000. Wait. You sell for a lot more, actually. Yeah, sure. I'll poof one of you. Okay, 5,000. But I gotta make sure y'all don't breed before they hatches. That'll be a problem. All right, let's poof two pigs, and let's see how the ostriches fare, and then we can probably, get rid of more pigs to get more ostriches. Okay, I swear I put it in here. There we are. Oh yes, here we go. If I accidentally eat it, I'm gonna kill myself. So let's just get past everything. Okay. There we go. It's in. Oh my god, what an episode it has been. Alright, I'm so glad we got so many things done. And it's been great. This update has been amazing. So I'm probably gonna make a video on my thoughts on the overall update. But as for now, just thanks for watching. It's been really fun working on these, and yeah, it's been really fun. Okay, let's chop this one down. And I hope I entertain you guys as well as I thought I did. Not the best at this, but I try to do my best. Okay, let's see. I can chop you since there's one growing next to you. And let's plant a seed over here. There we go. There's one growing next to you as well, so I can chop you down. Alright, so I need to gather another 40 pieces of hardwood. That's still a lot. Let's just go to the forest and continue this. So for me, it looks like this episode is, can be closed. Let's just check if Marnie for once is actually where I think she should be. No way. Marnie is the rarest thing in Stardew Valley. I swear, I can find six prismatic shards in a day, but not one Marnie. So that's it for me, guys. It's been amazing. See you soon.